على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد أفضل صلواتك بعدد معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه. So regarding irtidad, apostasy, how Imam Abu Hanifa Ayah number 219 Yas'alunaka, they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, anil khamri, about khamr wal maisir and gambling. قل سي او محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فيهما اسم كبير in them both is a major sin ومنافع للناس and some benefits for people وإثمهما أكبر من نفعهما but the sin of them is greater than the benefit of it. Got it? So again, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ, they ask you about الْخَمْرِ, the khamr, the wine, وَالْمَيْسِرِ, because in translation you will find there عَنِ الْخَمْرِ, the alcoholic drinks, but as we are Hanafis, so that's why I mentioned the wine. Yes, because khamr literally mean is wine only, not alcoholic drinks. Yes. يَسْأَلُونَكَ, they ask you عَنِ الْخَمْرِ, from about wine, وَالْمَيْسِرِ and gambling. قُلْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فِيمَا, in them both, اسْمُ الْكَبِيرٌ, there is a big sin. وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ, and some benefit for men. وَإِثْمُهُمَا أَكْبَرُ مِنْ لَفْعِهِمَا but the sin of them is greater than their benefit. So now, the word khamar, it is like this. Khamar. So Jamhur, they said about Khamar, كُلُّ مَا يُخَامِرُ الْعَقَلِ, whatsoever is putting a cover on your aqal and sense. It is putting a cover on your sense. That is called khamar. But Imam said, rahimahullah, annayyu, mimma il'inab, is ashtadda wa ghala wa qazafa bizzabad. Huwa nayyu min ma'il inab, that is the juice of grapes, is ashtadda wa ghala, when that is become thick, or that became thick, boiled, wa qazafa bizzabad, and throwing foams to its surface with boiling, it is bringing what? foam on its surface. In other words, yes, fermented grape juice. So Imam says, Rahimahullah, that before everything, you have to take this into consideration, because that is in dictionaries. That is where? So Imam says, all those people who wrote the dictionary, you cannot throw it somewhere in ocean. Got it? Because for words, people are going where? To dictionary. Got it? He said, this one, that is your definition. Got it? So first you will go to dictionary to find out what khamar means. So khamar means annayu mimma al-inab iza ishtadda wa ghala wa qazafa bil-zabad. When that became thick, wa ghala, boiled, wa qazafa bil-zabad, throwing out the foam, fermented. Got it? So that is khamar. So wherever khamar is mentioned, Imam says that is only wine. Got it? Other alcoholic drinks are not wine. They are alcoholic drinks only. Yes? Then Jamhur. They said another thing. Their Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Kullu ma askara kasiruhu, faqaliluhu haramun." Kullu ma askara kasiruhu. Any drink, when you will take it in plenty, it will make you drunk. So then a little bit of that material is also haram. Because making you drunk, that's the nature of that thing. Got it? So they said, look, number one, alcoholic drinks covers the aql and the intellect. And number two, Nuruddin, number two, it's taking in abundance will make one's drunk, so that is haram and prohibited. So that thing should be applied to, that is khamar. Imam says these are two different things. Certain things will be haram, but there will be no punishment, fixed punishment for that in Sharia. Yes? Got it? Imam says, I don't say that alcoholic drinks are not haram and prohibited. My only point is that is not khamar. So if that is not khamar, the had is not applied to that. That's the only thing. The had is not applied to that. There'll be a penalty. There'll be a penalty fixed by the legislature. Fixed by the legislature. Because at that time, the fuqaha used to say that penalty suggested by the qazi and by the judge. But now the things are changed. The legislature. You know what I'm saying? Because judges, they need something in black and white. They need something in black and white. Otherwise they say that in law we don't say and see anything about this. So the legislature, they have to give them something. But that is called ta'zir. Penalty is called ta'zir, which is less than had, so that is called ta'zir. And ta'zir is actually less than the minimum had, less than the minimum had for the first time. The minimum had for the first time. Then write it down that had or appointed punishment for khamr is ...40 stripes. It was in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the time of Umar, Osman and... ...the beginning of the rule of Ali. But then Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, based on ijma, fixed it as 80. Instead of 40? Because people were very strong to carry 40 stripes very easily. It was not stopping them from drinking. Yes? And the purpose of had is to stop them from drinking. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, he said that in Holy Quran for qazaf, for what? Qazaf. False charges about a chaste person, or regarding a chaste person, against a chaste person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَجْلِدُوهُمْ سَمَانِينَ جَلْدًا. 80 stripes are mentioned there in Surah Nur. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, he made a statement. Nuruddin, he said, فَإِنَّهُ إِذَا شَرِبَ سَكَرُ. وَإِذَا سَكَرَ هَذَا. وَإِذَا هَذَا قَذَفْ. وَإِذَا قَذَفْ جُلِّدَ سَمَنِينَ. وَإِذَا قَذَفْ then Nuruddin Julie the Samani. Look here. He said when somebody drinks wine, he becomes drunk. When someone is drunk, he is saying hafawat. He does not know what he is speaking. Hafawat, let's call hizyan or hafawat. Yes. Using bad words. Wa idha haza. When somebody starts using bad words, qazafa, he will step into the dignity, honor, and respect of people as well. Yes? Means saying false thing against someone because he is drunk. And whenever somebody says false thing against someone, so for him, the punishment in Holy Quran is? Got it? So again, يَسْأَلُونَكَ they ask you عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ about khamar, wine. والميسر ان جيمبلين قل سيو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما اسم كبير ان them both there is a big sin. ومنافع للناس and some benefits for men. وإثمهما أكبر من نفعهما and the sin of them is greater than their benefits. ويسألونك ماذا ينفقون and they ask you ماذا ينفقون. That what they ought to spend or they should spend. Because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Holy Quran time and again was saying spend, spend, spend. So they asked the Prophet, what should we spend? وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ and they ask you مَا زَيُنْفِقُونَ what should they spend? So now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have said, $1,000. Yes. That would have become a rule. That would have become a rule. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention any specific amount. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, Az-Zahab, spend the gold. So what about silver? Spend the gold. So what about dollars? Spend food, so what about money? You know what I'm saying? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used a very comprehensive word. And that is, قُلْ سَيْءُ مُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ سَلَّمْ أَلْغَفُ anything which is beyond your need. Look, what a beautiful word. Only one word. أَلْغَفُ anything which is beyond your need, whatever you don't need, spend it in the path of Allah. Give it to others. And that's what Sahaba used to do. Abu Sa'id Khudri says, Raziyallahu ta'ala an, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed us. So he said, Man kana lahu fazlu zadin falyu'id bihi ila man la zada lahu. Whosoever have extra food, he should give it to someone who does not have it. وَمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ فَضْلُ رَكْبٍ فَلْيُعِدْ بِهِ إِلَىٰ مَنْ لَا رَكْبَ لَهُ. Whosoever having an extra ride, he should give it to someone who does not have it. So Sahaba, those who had extra donkeys, camels or horses, they give it to those who did not have it. فَذَكَرَ مِنْ أَصْنَافِ الْمَالِ Abu Sa'id says, what Nuruddin? فَذَكَرَ مِنْ أَصْنَافِ الْمَالِ حَتَّى ظَنَنَّا أَنَّهُ لَحَقَّ لِحَدٍ مِنَّا فِي فَضْلٍ فَذَكَرَ مِنْ أَصْنَافِ الْمَالِ Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned different types of belongings, the clothes, the shoes and things like that. That whosoever has extra cloth, he should give it to someone who does not have. Extra shoes, he should give it to someone who does not have it. Hatta zananna. He said that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was giving us a list till we thought annahu la haqqa li hadin minna fi fazlin. That nobody has an undisputed right in a thing which belongs to him, but that is beyond his need. So it means something which is beyond your need. So to some extent that is disputed. That disputed means that certain other hungry people, they have their due right in that food of yours. Certain naked people, they have their due right in that dress of yours. Certain barefooted people, they have a due right in your shoes, which is extra beyond your need. Got it? حَتَّى ظَنَنَّا أَنَّهُ لَحَقَّ لِحَدٍ مِنَّا فِي فَضْلٍ So Jassas rahmatullahi alayhi, Abu Bakr Jassas, he's a great mufassir, he's a Hanafi. His tafsir is very famous. تفسير احكام القران, تفسير احكام القران. He did not explain the whole Quran, only the ayat which has fiqhi rules, yes, which is the source of laws. The ayat are the verses which are the source of laws and rules. So he explained that. So he explained this one as well, because it has rule. It has rule. Infaq. Infaq is a rule. That's fiqh. That's a law.
كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ In the same way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes clear lakum for you people al-ayati
the verses.
لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَفَكَّرُونَ That you may give thought to it.
You may give?
فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ In this worldly life and in the hereafter. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ And they ask you عَنِ الْيَتَامَى About orphans.
They ask you about orphans.
قُلْ سَيْ أَوْ مُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ سَلَّمُ إِصْلَاحُ اللَّهُ خِيرٌ The best thing for orphans is to work honestly in their property.
Their islah, their good. Their good is good for them. Think of their good, that is good for them. Because certain people, they had orphans in their custody. They were taking care of orphans. So they asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Islahu lahum khair. Their good for them is good for them. Means, think good of them, that is good for them. So if you will think of their property, that if that is like this and so, it will vanish. So let's invest the property of this yatim. But you will act like a prudent person. Like a prudent person. There is a legal maxim, Mura'atul Maslaha. Mura'at al-Maslaha. To think of their Maslaha and their good. Whosoever is under your custody, or you are the custodian, or you are the guardian. So that is maslaha. That is what? That is maslaha. And that's why the fuqaha, based on that legal maxim, they have said that the khalifa, or whosoever in authority in any way, he must think of the maslaha of those who are under his custody. A khalifa, or a person in authority, he cannot do such an act which goes against the maslaha of those who are under his custody, which goes against the good of those who are under his custody. Got it? And that's why most of the time, especially in underdeveloped country or developing countries, where the rulers or people in authority, they are not that much careful. So that's why, especially in Pakistan, for example. In Pakistan, the rulers are not that much careful. So the Supreme Court takes a so moto action. In certain cases, they take a so moto action. For example, they sold one property in Islamabad. Yes, less than the market price. And they sold the steel mill in Karachi, less than the market price on the basis of privatization. The basis of privatization. And Supreme Court took a so moto action and stopped it. Yes, they stopped it. Yes, and bring all the papers and the auctions and, you know what I'm saying? We will look into the matter. Because that is the public property, and public property should not go like this. Got it? God or not. Otherwise, people in authority, they can say, we are the authority. We can do whatever. No, you are the authority to the extent of maslaha. To the extent of maslaha. You cannot sell the state. You cannot sell people. You cannot sell public property like this. Got it?
وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ دِعَاسُ عَنِ الْيَتَامَا about orphans قُلْ سَيُوْ مُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ سَلَّمْ إِصْلَاحُ اللَّهُمْ خِيرٌ that good for them is good for them. وَإِن تُخَالِتُمْ and sometime a brother who had a small brother under his custody who was an orphan and he was an equal partner in the property of their father after his death. Yes? So now this big brother, he was the owner of his share. But he was the guardian of the share of his yatim brother. You know what I'm saying? So now, they were in little bit difficulty that I cannot handle two properties separately. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, okay, you can mix it, but as a brother. You can mix it as a brother, not as a responsible for your family. For example, you are married, yes, and you had fertility, alhamdulillah, and you have 10 sons and daughters. Yes, and your brother, he is small. He is not married yet. He is orphan. Now if you are spending the property combined and jointly, 50-50, that is haram. Because he is not responsible for your children. His property should not be spent for your children. You know what I am saying? You will spend from your own property on your kids. So it means if you are a husband and wife and 10 kids, and he is only one, yes? So you are buying stuff. So you will put $12 from your side and $1 from his side. From your property will be $12 and from his property will be $1 because he is one guy and you are 12. And if you will say, oh, 50-50. What do you think? What you mean 50-50? These are your kids or his kids? So that's why Allah said, in one single word, He said, وَإِن تُخَالِتُمْ فَيَخْوَانُكُمْ. Got it? وَإِن تُخَالِتُمْ and if you mix your affairs with them, فَيَخْوَانُكُمْ then they are your brothers. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْمُفْسِدَ and Allah knows him who means mischief. مِنَ الْمُصْلِحِ from him who means good.
Mufsid is someone who is spreading disorder. And Muslihim, someone who is doing good. Who is doing good?
Wallahu ya'lamu al-mufsida min al-muslih.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are cheating in a hidden way, in a secret way, with that orphan, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I am the actual guardian of him. So think about the day of judgment, what will happen to you.
وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْمُفْسِدَ and Allah knows al-mufsida, one who is spreading mischief min al-muslihi, from one who is practicing good. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ and if Allah wills, لَآنَتَكُمْ he could have put you into difficulties. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ truly Allah is almighty and all-wise. وَلَا تَنْكِهُ الْمُشْرِكَاتِ and do not marry the mushrik ladies حَتَّى يُؤْمِنَّ till they believe. وَالْعَمَةُ الْمُؤْمِنَةُ and indeed a slave woman is خَيْرٌ better مِنْ مُشْرِكَةٍ then a mushrika, even though if she is a free lady.
A mushrika is a free, and this mumina is a slave lady. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, a slave lady is better than a mushrika, even though if she is a free woman.
Walau ajabatkum, even though ajabatkum, her beauty pleases you.
Even though the beauty of Desh Mushrika is pleasing you. Got it? But that is not the first priority. Chastity is the first priority. And the basic chastity is Iman. The basic chastity is Iman.
وَلَا تُنْكِهُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ and do not marry your daughters or your sisters الْمُشْرِكِينَ
to Mushrik men.
حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا till they believe وَلَعَبْدُ الْمُؤْمِنُ الْأَسْلَيُ
a woman who is a slave.
A slave believer is خَيْرٌ better than مِن مُشْرِكٍ from a Mushrik one وَلَوْ عَاجَبَكُمْ
even though if his stature or his handsomeness or his richness pleases you. But what you will do with a mushrik? And I'm sorry to say, now that is our priority. We do not think of the akhlaqiyat of anybody, the character of anybody. Yes? We do think about, he has a black Mercedes. Yes. Maybe he does not have it. Yes, he rented it. It happened to so many people. And later on, they found out, oh, this guy did not have anything. Yes, and I'm sorry to say it because you know your own community. What's their priority? Tawzian, I'm right?
وَلَا تُلْكِهُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا وَلَعَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ أَسْلَوْ بِلِيُرْ خَيْرٌ is better مِن مُشْرِكٍ from a مُشْرِك وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكُمْ even though لَوْ أَعْجَبَكُمْ if his stature or his features or his richness pleases you أُولَٰئِكَ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ these مُشْرِك people they are calling you towards a blazing fire.
They are inviting you towards blazing fire.
Wallahu yad'u and Allah invites and calls you ila al-jannah towards paradise wal maghfira and forgiveness bi izni with his leave. Wa yubayyinu ayati lin-nasi and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains his ayat lin-nasi to people. La'allahum yatazakkarun that they may
think about that. Tazakkur is tafahum. What tazakkur huwa? At-tafahum. Those who are trying to understand. Who are trying to?
وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْمَحِيدُ
Now, in that area, there were two people and they were people of the book. Number one, Jew. Number two, Christians. Jew were on one extreme regarding women in periods. And Christians were on the other extreme regarding women in period. So the Jews, when any woman was in period, they were not taking a water cup from their hand even. That they are dirty. Not only they, putting her for these many days in confinement in a separate room. And throwing them food from outside. They do not mingle with family. Do not mingle with family. On the other hand, the Christians, they used to do sexual intercourse even in period. One were on one extreme and the others one? Other extreme. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is wrong and that is wrong. The right is in between. The right is in between. No sexual intercourse, that is prohibited. Yes, but nothing is wrong with her body. Nothing is wrong with her body. She can cook you a food, she can make you a tea, She can give you a water. Got it? She can mingle and mix with family and with people. Got it?
وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ And they ask you عَنِ الْمَحِيضِ About menstruation. قُلْ Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم هُوَ أَذَن قُلْ Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم هُوَ أَذَن
That is harmful. That is what? Harmful. Azan doesn't mean that that is filth, so do not go close to them or do not speak to them. قُلْ هُوَ أَذَن That is harmful. وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَذَن كَثِيرًا So what the أَذَن mean is there? Harmful words. Rudin, when we say something, so Quran is there.